Hello students, welcome to a lesson through the virtual training center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagarpalika. My name is Shraddha teacher, and in this lockdown period, since we are not able to go to school children, we will be doing many lessons here online through the virtual class. So come on, let's proceed to our lesson for today.
So children, I'm back with what we were doing last time. Remember, I told you that we are going to continue the lesson that we were doing last time. So we were doing the lesson in standard third, and the subject was EVS. And remember which lesson we were doing? Yes, it was lesson number 13 from our textbook. So we talked about our diet in that particular lesson. And when I finished the video there, I told you that the next time we meet, we are going to continue with this lesson and learn some more things about our diet. So here I am back with part 2 of the lesson, our diet. So come on, let's see first what we have talked about last time, and then we will move on and study some more new things which are there in the lesson for us. So last time children, we studied what the meaning of diet is. So whatever we eat during the course of the day, so whether it is fruits, whether it is vegetables, whether it is grains, or even you can say masalas or the spices, all these things, they are part of our diet. So diet in one way is equal to the food that we eat. So this is what we learned in the lesson last time, isn't it? And we also learned that whatever food that we eat during the day, during one particular day, is called as our diet for that particular day. We also saw children that diet means all these things which you eat. Now, which are the things that we need to eat also we discussed. Okay, for example, we discussed that we need to eat vegetables, we need to eat fruits, we need to drink milk and consume so many milk products. Like for example, we have ghee, we have butter, we have curd, which we call as dahi, then we have paneer, cheese. So all these things, they give us a lot of good values to our body. Okay, they are very healthy for our body, so we should eat all these things. Then we discuss that people who are okay with eating non-vegetarian food should eat chicken, they should eat fish, they should eat meat, eggs, etc. And last but not the least, we should also include grains in our diet. So grains, cereals, pulses, so all these things ideally should be part of our diet on a daily basis. So this is what food that we should be eating on a daily basis. Then in the lesson last time, we also learned that according to the age of a person, like for example, this is a small baby, and these are children who are around 6 and 7 and 8 years old, and then these are a little bit elder children, and then you have adults, and then you have old people. Okay, so we discussed that the diet of the people changes according to the age of a person. So when a person is young, that person requires more food because that person is working hard, isn't it? Going to the office, coming back, doing some work, working in the kitchen. But when a person becomes a little old, that person stops going to work and they stop doing heavy work also. So their diet also should change. So we saw that according to the age of the person, the diet differs. Okay, we also saw that diet also differs according to the kind of work that we do. So people who do heavy work, like people who do a lot of physical work. Okay, you must have seen these people who work on the road construction sites, etc. They need more energy, so they need more food. Whereas people who always sit in front of the computer and work, they are not getting up, they are not moving around. They might be using their mind, but they do not use their body so much. So these people should eat lesser, or they should eat different kind of food. Okay, so people doing physical work require more food. So this is what we learned last time. Now in today's lesson, let us talk about one more difference that is there in society. We have men in society and we have women in society. isn't it? So we have boys and we have girls around us. But even though they are different to look at, and even though their bodies are different, they are equal in society. So man and woman, they are equal in society. Boy and girl, they are equal in society. That means they should be able to get equal education. Now this is happening, isn't it? When you look around in your class, you will see that half of your class is made up of boys and the other half is girls. So if you have 15 boys, you almost have 15 and 16 girls in class. So boys and girls, men and women should get equal education, isn't it? They should also get equal job opportunities. Job opportunities means they should be given equal chance to work. So if a woman is very smart and if she goes to get a job, then they should not tell her, no, you cannot work because you're a woman. So see, men and women, they should get equal job opportunities also. Now there are many places where women and men are working on equal level. For example, see here, you will see a woman, here you will see a woman working, here along with a man you will see a woman sitting, okay? So everywhere you look around in society, you will see that women are also working equally along with the men. Alright, now places where women were never working before, for example, driving auto rickshaws, etc., also you will see nowadays women are working. So women get equal job opportunities also. So there is a very important thing that they should be equal in. They should get equal diet also. Sometimes children, this does not happen, but because in some societies, the boys are considered to be more important than the girls. That is why the boys are given good food to eat, whereas the girls are not given equal amount and equal quality of food. Not everywhere. It will not happen in houses where we are all educated, but in some places it might happen. But that should not happen. So boys and girls, they should get equal diet also. Just like they're getting equal education, they're getting equal amount of jobs, they should get equal diet also. See, look at this picture and tell me whether this is right or wrong. See, the boy is getting so much to eat, isn't it? He's got a plate full of food and he's also got milk in his glass. But look at the poor girl. She's got just one roti and they have given a little sabji or something and water. So what do you think, children? According to you, is this right or is this wrong? This is totally wrong. If you see this kind of thing happening around you, or if someone is doing it to you also, you should raise your voice and say that this is wrong. This should not be done. Okay? Boys and girls should get equal amount of diet also. Now, see, when the boy is eating something, the man is eating something, the woman also should be allowed to eat the same thing. Their diet should be equal, because nowadays both of them are working equally. All right, so the diet of men and women should be equal. Now let us talk about another concept regarding our diet. Now what do you see on the plate here? You see some rotis, all right, or chapatis, or bread, flat bread. It is called in English. We call it roti, we call it chapati, we call it bhakri in our language. But in English, you call it flat bread. So now these are chapatis. Now suppose your mummy one day, she gets up in the morning and she gives you chapati for breakfast. Okay, for morning nashta, she gives you chapati. In the lunch again, at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, she gives you chapatis again. We learnt now that we have breakfast in the morning, lunch in the afternoon, and dinner at night. So in the afternoon for lunch, again you're getting chapatis. What about dinner? Let us see whether she gives you something different. No, for dinner also she gives you chapatis. Imagine what will happen to you. Will you be very happy and excited? No. In fact, you will start looking like this, bored, isn't it? The next time you see chapati, you will look like this. And you will tell your mother or you will tell your mummy, no, I do not want to eat this. That means there should be variety in our food. Variety means we should be eating different kinds of food. Not only because our body needs it, but also because if you eat the same kind of food, you will get bored. Okay, so there should be variety in our food. So see here, so many things on the plate, isn't it? So there are chapatis also, there are different types of sabji also, there are some chutneys also. So you have variety. And when you have variety, then you get interest in eating it. Alright, so that is why one day your mummy makes a cabbage ka sabji, the second day she makes brinjal ka sabji, and the third day again she makes palak ka sabji. Isn't it? She keeps on changing, na? Because if she gives you cabbage ka sabji every day, there will be no variety and you will get very, very bored. Alright, so see, there should be a lot of variety in what you eat. So in the morning, if you're eating something, in the evening, you should not eat the same food. You should try to avoid the same thing and you should try to eat something else. All right. And there is no need to spend a lot of money to eat different kind of food every day. One morning you can have, afternoon you can have one sabji. The next afternoon you can have some other sabji. So there should be variety in food. So see, if you eat only fruits, you'll get bored. If you eat only vegetables, you'll get bored. So everything should be mixed up. You should not eat the same thing every day. And you should mix up things in your diet. Alright? So there should be variety in food. See? Variety is there, na? One place they're eating bhakri and some kadhi and something else. Other place people are eating non-vegetarian food. And then there is some other kind of curry. So when you get variety, you will like to eat also. You will not get bored. Now children, some places in India. India is a large, very huge, expansive country. We know that, na? So in India also, you will see that the diet of the people goes on changing. So in some places, rice grows abundantly. There are lots of rice fields. There is a lot of rain. So because of the heavy rain, there is a lot of water. And for the paddy or for rice field, they require a lot of water. So there are many places in India where rice is grown on a large scale. And because rice is grown on a large scale, these people eat rice also on a large scale. For example, see all these states here. So most of the South Indian states, most of the states on the eastern side, in all these places, rice is grown in huge quantities. So people here, they eat rice, they eat bhat, that is they make cook rice and they eat, they make bhakris out of rice. So whatever is available to people, that they eat. So see, you can see all the places where rice is eaten. Now certain places in India, they are near the sea coast. Can you see all the places which are marked with blue ink? They are all on the sea coast. Now sea coast means what? Water is very close to them. The sea is very close to them. And then what is available in the sea in plenty? Yes, very good. You had fish in plenty available in the seas. Okay, so these people go fishing and they catch a lot of fish and they eat the fish also. So for many people, fish is a very important part of their diet, especially people in Goa, people in Kerala, people in some parts of Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal. They eat fish in large quantities. And in some places, that is the staple diet, fish and rice. Staple means something which they eat almost every day, fish and rice. Okay, so people eat according to the place where they are living. Okay, so people live in places where rice is available, they eat rice in large quantities. If they're living in places where it is close to the sea and their fish is available, they eat fish in large quantities. So this is also how there is variety in the food in which people eat. So see, when people live close to the seashore, they catch fish and they eat fish. They even sell fish for a living. So this is a koli. A lady who's a fishmonger or fish seller. Alright, so they go to the sea, they catch fish and they sell it out. Alright, and that is how they earn a living and they also eat fish in large quantities. Now children, we eat also according to the fruits and vegetables which are available to us according to the season. So in the month of April, which fruit can you see around you? Mangoes, isn't it? So in the month of April and May, wherever you go, you will see mangoes. People selling baskets of mangoes, people selling boxes of mangoes. Everywhere you go, you will see mango milkshake is available, mango lassi is available. So there are many fruits, there are many vegetables which are seasonal in nature. That is, they come out only in certain seasons. For example, see, from the November to February, that is the winter months, okay, when we have the winter season, you will be able to see oranges a lot in the market, you will be able to see apples in the market, grapes, pomegranates, kiwi, papaya, dates. So these are the winter fruits. So whichever fruit is available to you in the season, according to the season, those fruits you should eat in good quantities. Okay, the same thing goes with the vegetables also. See, these are the summer vegetables. That is vegetables which are available from March to June. So you get a lot of, you can say, leafy vegetables are there. Then you have kaddu, then you have the musk melon, you have carrots and so many other vegetables which are available in the summer months. So you should have that in huge quantities. So whichever vegetable is available in the market, that you should have. Okay. Now there are special foods for special occasions also. So there are certain days when your mummy makes something very special and you're very happy. For example, suppose it is Holi. Alright, so do you remember what your mummy makes for Holi specially? Yes, she makes Puran Polis, isn't it? For Diwali, do you know what we make? We make Karanjis, we make Laddus. Alright, so there are special foods for special occasions. On special days, we eat special kind of meals. So these are called as festive foods. Okay, foods which we eat for festivals. Now, imagine if you have a Muslim friend and that Muslim friend calls you home for his festival. It is Eid. And your Muslim friend invites you for Eid. He says, come home to have lunch. What will he serve you? He will serve you biryani, isn't it? And also sheer kurma. So isn't your mouth watering? So there are special dishes or there are special meals made for special occasions like festivals. Okay, so on such days we have special meals. But children, whether you have a special meal, whether you have seasonal food, whether you have food which is available in your area, you should always try to eat healthy food. Alright, food which will help your body to grow better. Now let us look at an example about food which is healthy and which is not healthy. So what is very important for us? We should eat food which is healthy. Okay, so see, all these things come in the category of healthy foods. So if you just give a glance, you will be able to see that most of them belong to the fruit and vegetable category, the family of fruits and vegetables. Okay. So the other things that we tend to eat like biscuits, they are not here on this page. That means that they might not be very healthy for us. We eat them because we like the taste, but they might not be very healthy for our bodies. Now let us look at what you should eat on a daily basis. So see, this is a child's plate. So on the plate, you should have some fruits. You should have some healthy protein. Healthy protein means fish or eggs or chicken. You should have some whole grains. So we Indians, we eat lots of chapatis. We eat bhakri. Okay, we eat rice. So that is whole grain. You should also eat some vegetables. And a little bit oil is also important for us. Along with that, you should have water and you should have something made up of milk. Either curd or butter or anything else. So this is how a healthy plate should look like. some fruits, some vegetables, some whole grains, some proteins, water, little oil, and some dairy product. Okay. Now, sometimes children, we also eat sprouts. You must have seen sprouts like this, and green leafy vegetables. Okay. These are also very important. So eating sprouts. Sprouts means what? You must have seen moog, matki, etc. What do? You soak it in water and you tie it up. Okay. And then it starts growing. So when it starts growing, the content of protein in it increases. So it becomes very healthy. And then you also have these green leafy vegetables. Isn't it? You have methi. Now this is the season for methi. We were talking about seasonal vegetables. Now a lot you will be able to see people selling methi. So you have methi, you have dhania, then you have mat, that is called as amaranth. You have curry leaves. Okay. You have lettuce. See, there are so many things in this. You have a radish. So all these things are very, very healthy. They are very, very important for our body. Okay, so you should try to eat them. Now let us come to some kind of food which we do not like at all. Okay, so I have picked up a few kind of food which I do not like. So there might be some kind of vegetables and fruits which you do not like. So see, I do not like to eat karela at all. Karela, bitter gourd. What is the reason? It is so bitter. So whether you make it into a sabji or whether you make it into a curry, it is very bitter. So I do not like to even see the karela on my plate. The same thing goes with this pumpkin or kaddu, as you call it. Okay. Or with this doodi or bottle gourd. It doesn't have any taste. So I do not like to eat it. But does it mean that I should not eat it? At least once in a week, I should try to eat these kind of vegetables also. Even though I do not like them, because it is very important for our body to eat all kinds of vegetables. Okay, so the bitter gourd might be very bitter, but it is good for our body. Okay, so try to include things which you do not like. You don't like them, so don't eat them every day, but at least try to eat them once in a while. Once in a week is enough. Okay, so never tell your mummy that no, you're going to make kaddu and I'm not going to eat. Never say that. Okay, at least try to eat it once in a week. So you might be having your own vegetables which you don't like. Some people don't like bengan, that is brinjals. Okay, some people don't like ladyfinger, bindi some people don't like. But you should eat it at least once in a week. All right. Now let us come to the other category of food. Now we saw what is healthy food. Now let us move on and talk about some other category of food. Now when we saw these vegetables, you do not like them at all. No one likes them. What about such things? So do you like these things? What are these? Chips and cold drink. Oh my God, most of us like them. Isn't it? Chips and cold drink we like. But are they healthy for us? That is, are they good for our body? Let us see. No, they are very unhealthy. So chips, they have lots of salt, lots of oil. Okay, it is very oily. So if you eat it, you will become fat. All right. What about cold drinks? Cold drinks, drinking things which are very cold is not at all good for health. Point number one. Second point is, if you drink these cold drinks, they have sugar, they have color in large quantities. So these things actually, they are very tasty to the tongue. When you eat them, you love the taste, but it is very, very bad for health. They are unhealthy. So now come on, let us take a look at all those things which are not good for our body and which we should try to avoid. Okay. Now it is not possible for us to not at all eat chips and not at all drink cold drinks. So like I told you, you should try to eat the vegetables which you don't like once in a while. In the same way, these unhealthy things also you should try to avoid. Eat it only once in a while. So once in a week, have some chips. Once in 15 days, have a bottle of cold drink, but not every day. Don't make it a habit. All right. So see, these are things which you should try to avoid. All right. For example, these kind of pastries and pizza. See, it contains so much of oil. It contains, they put too much of butter and cheese. See, too much of butter is not good. Too much of cheese is not good. Okay, and they also have soda in them, baking soda and baking powder, lots and lots of sugar, and they have color, okay, which will eventually make you sick. Not immediately, but slowly and slowly it will damage your body. So we should try to avoid eating these things. Avoid them. You cannot stop eating them completely, but you should start by avoiding them. Eat little. If someone gives you one big pizza, cut out a small piece from it and eat. Don't eat the whole pizza. All right. See, we already talked about chips and we talked about cold drinks. So see the amount of sugar which is there in this cold drink. Can you see all the sugar cubes here? So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 spoons of sugar in one glass of cold drink. So see how much sugar is going into your body. What about these potato fries? There is so much oil in them, isn't it? So it is not good for you. Try to avoid these things also. Okay, what else? Let us see what other things. Again, we have all these Fryams, the potato chips, the rings. Okay, all these things, the kurkure, everything that you eat, they are very tasty. So when you open one packet, you go on eating, you go on eating, you go on eating, isn't it? Which is very bad for your health. They are very, very unhealthy. Try not to eat these things also. And what about chocolates? Once in a while, eating chocolates is okay. But do not make it a habit to eat chocolates every day, because you know that sweets are not good for our teeth. Every time you eat sweets, you're supposed to brush your teeth. So do you do that? Most of us don't. So it is better to avoid eating this also. So then what will you eat? You will eat all the healthy things that we talked about. Okay, you will eat lots of vegetables, you will eat lots of fruits, you will eat whole grain, because in this pizza there is grain, but it is maida, which is a refined flour, which is not good for you. All right, children. So we talked so many things about our diet. We discussed about what we should eat, what we shouldn't eat. We also discussed about how the diet of people is different according to their age. Okay, so someone who's young eats differently. Someone who's old eats differently. We also discussed how people should eat according to their health. So if you're sick, you should not eat heavy food. You should eat light food. We also saw that people who do heavy work, they tend to eat a lot of food. They should eat a lot of food. And then we discussed the most important thing, that is, which foods should we avoid eating. So that was our lesson about diet in two parts.
So children, wasn't that a wonderful video? And did you enjoy watching it? So if you want to watch more such videos in future, then please like this video and also subscribe to our channel, the MCGM Portal for Education, and also hit the bell button so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video here. Thank you so much for now. Let's meet again soon.